This is the Russian River Valley in Northern California, where gravel pits dug in the 70s, 80s, 90s, and even in the 2000s have been abandoned. And that's the common, the normal practice for gravel mining in alluvial valleys. Our fisheries experts are doing some sampling in these pits to see what fish are living in them now, and also doing some water quality measurements for temperature and DO and conductivity to see what species they might be suitable to support. We are looking for some anas out here. We're just not expecting to find them.
What we found is completely 100% introduced species, at least with this sample here. This is a largemouth bass, native of the South, Louisiana, swamplands. And what we see, by drastically changing the landscape, we're setting up habitat for introduced species, which is a voracious predator. And so these ponds get flooded every year, and likely thousands of juvenile salmon and steelhead get washed in here and then stranded in here. Well, rather than contributing to the population, they end up being food for introduced species.
I've been working in fisheries for about 12 years now, and it's really been a great education for me to try to make the connections between habitat and salmon. We're finding that they move around a lot more than we anticipated before, and they use a lot richer and more diverse habitats, and in particular, off-channel habitats. They need the floodplains, particularly in this Mediterranean environment, which is a rich winter feeding opportunity, to get out on a floodplain where earthworms and insects come up, and they can really grow fast. And size is everything for salmon. When they head to the ocean, the bigger they are, the more likely they are to return to the watershed. We're engaged in a feasibility study in partnership with California Coastal Conservancy, Sonoma County, California Fish and Wildlife, and of course NOAA Fisheries, and some NGOs and the landowner, Hansen Materials. And this project is looking at the feasibility of recontouring this entire landscape, not just simply making some small connections between the river and a gravel pit, but actually recontouring all the land we're standing on here, the land around them, so that we can create floodplains, wetlands, off-channel habitats, meander bends, oxbows, all kinds of really complex and more importantly, dynamic habitats connected to the river that have been removed from this alluvial valley landscape for 300 years.
So by transforming the landscape into something that is seasonally natural, it wouldn't even be wet during this time of year. And so these types of predators wouldn't be able to thrive in this system.
Recovery of salmon, in my mind, is going to be predicated on our ability to find and restore opportunities like this, where there's space to create off-channel habitat.